Bhaktimarandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chaksurmilitanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine. Namaste Sarasati Devi Kauravani Precharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschachade Satarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're narrating the pastimes of a cowherd boy from Govardhan named Gop Kumar, who had travelled to the spiritual world. I think gone to Goloka Vrindavan, and he found out that Goloka Vrindavan is not different from Vrindavan on earth. So we're hearing how Sukadeva Goswami describes all the different people in Vrindavan, all the different living entities in Vrindavan, how they're all devotees of Krishna.
Sukadeva Goswami 描述了文达文的人,文达文的生物,他们都是Krishna的亲密的奉献者。
He began by speaking about the clouds over Vrindavan are devotees, and the rivers flowing through Vrindavan are devotees, and the trees and the forests in Vrindavan are all devotees.
文达文的云,文达文上空的云朵是奉献者,文达文的河流是奉献者,文达文森林的树木也都是奉献者。
And the birds and the different animals like the cows and the buffalo and the goats, they're all devotees in Vrindavan.
那里的鸟类,那里的动物们,比如说牛, 母牛,
what's special about these connected to Krishna? Actually, these cowherd boys had all performed pious activities for many lives, and in this way they were able to play with Krishna.
做了大量的虔诚活动，可以在今生和Krishna一起玩耍。The
Gyanis, they're impersonalists, they only can understand the bliss of the Brahman.
那些思辨家们，他们只是非人格主义者。
And there are devotees who are not like the devotees in Vrindavan. They just have the mood of being eternal servants of Krishna.
Krishna
And then you've got people who are not devotees at all, they're just ordinary people in the material world. And they think Krishna is also just an ordinary child. They don't understand Krishna's transcendental position.
还有的是根本就不是奉献者的人，他们只是物质世界的普通人而已，他们也把Krishna当成物质世界的普通小孩，他们根本就不理解Krishna的超然地位。
So Sukadeva Goswami was describing the very great fortune, good fortune of these cowherd boys, how they were able to play with Krishna.
Sukadeva Goswami 描述了这些牧牛童们的好运，他们是极其幸运的，可以跟 Krishna 一起玩耍。
So they were able to associate very intimately with Krishna and to experience that happiness of just being with Krishna, which is so much greater than the happiness of impersonal Brahman.
是远远超越于觉悟了非人格饭的快乐。Krishna
is actually the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and he is worshipped by all saintly persons, but only special persons are allowed the privilege to enter into his pastimes.
Krishna 是至尊性格神手，他受到圣人们的崇拜，但是只有那些特殊的灵魂才被允许拥有进入到 Krishna 消失光的特权。So
all of his friends in Vrindavan are liberated souls, and they take part in his pastimes, and they experience that happiness.
Krishna 的所有朋友们，Vrindavan的朋友们，全部都是解脱的灵魂，他们可以参加 Krishna 的Vrindavan的消时光，并且体验到超然的快乐。Most
people, however, are not liberated. There are Mayavadis who are bewildered by the power of the Supreme Lord, and they think of Krishna as an ordinary cowherd boy.
大部分人都是假象中人士，他们内心非常困惑，他们对于至尊主的力量并不了解，他们也根本无法参加 Krishna 的消时光。And
then there's some people who they want to understand spiritual knowledge. They're trying to find to get spiritual knowledge, so they understand Krishna as the impersonal Brahman, that he's coming from the impersonal Brahman.
还有的人呢，他们的目标只是去理解灵性知识，他们把 Krishna 呢当成非人格的饭，他们认为 Krishna 是来自于非人格的饭。So
they get some happiness from knowing the impersonal Brahman in that way.
他们以这种方式也能够得到些许快乐。But
the Vaishnava devotees, they consider themselves Krishna's servants, and Krishna is the master, and he gives himself to his devotees to be controlled by them.
Vaishnava 奉献者们把自己当作 Krishna 的仆人。 把 Krishna 当成主人，而 Krishna 把他自己给予他的奉献者，让他的奉献者控制他。Krishna's
pure devotees have so much love for Krishna that they can conquer over the material nature.
Krishna 的纯粹奉献者。 怀着如此深厚的爱，他们甚至征服了物质自然。
Now the gopis, the unmarried girls, they performed the worship. They would perform their worship. They would worship goddess Katyayini so that they could get Krishna as their husband.
得到Krishna为自己的丈夫。
So they would see Krishna just as a very handsome, attractive youth.
在他们的眼里,
they didn't think of Krishna as God.
他们不认为Krishna是神。
No, they just put their attention on Krishna, they wanted him for their husband.
他们的注意力放在 Krishna 身上，是因为他们想让 Krishna 做他们自己的丈夫。
So that same Krishna, who is the companion of the cowherd boys, is also is very appealing to these gopis. They want to have him for their husband.
同一位 Krishna, 这位牧牛童的同伴，他吸引了牧牛姑娘。牧牛姑娘们都想让 Krishna 成为他们自己的夫君。
So you see, everybody in Vrindavan, they're all loving Krishna in different ways. So, of course, Krishna's attraction is going to be, the attraction is going to be there more towards the gopis because they're women. So it would be more natural to have a loving conjugal relationship with the opposite sex.
Krishna的吸引力在牧牛姑娘这方面来说尤其显著，因为异性相吸，这些牧牛姑娘们，她们自然而然的对Krishna有
Now the gopis, they think that every human being is like them, and they think that everyone wants to, that everyone has love of Krishna. Men and women, everybody is loving Krishna.
无论男女都爱Krishna。
So the devotees who, some devotees, of course there's different levels of how we serve. Some people will be servants of Krishna, and then the servants of Krishna, they're on a higher level than people like jnanis. But the gopis, they're higher than the servants.
奉献者们分为不同层次奉献者，有些是仆人层面的奉献者，他们要比那些家里自便家的层面要高，但是勾毗牧牛姑娘，他们甚至高于Krishna的仆人。So
in this statement, Sukadeva Goswami is glorifying the cowherd boys, but he, at the same time, you can also understand that he's also glorifying the gopis.
Sukadeva Goswami, 通过这一席话，好像是在荣耀那些牧牛童，但是与此同时，他也在赞美那些奉献者。 同时还有一头荣耀的牧牛姑娘。
As we said, the cowherd boys, they had to perform many pious activities over many lifetimes in order to play with Krishna.
前面说过，牧牛童们为了跟 Krishna 共同玩耍，生生世世做了大量的前程活动。
It means they were not just ordinary pious activity, but they were actually offering sacrifices for the pleasure of the Supreme Lord.
这些不是普通的虔诚活动，他们为了取悦至尊主，做了大量的祭祀。
It is said that religious principles are the actual religious principles are whatever leads us to take up devotional service.
据说，就是真正的宗教虔诚活动可以将一个人导致奉爱服的层面。
So these great souls who were actually doing meditation on Krishna, later they became Krishna's friends.
因此，这些冥想 Krishna 的伟大灵魂们，后来都成为了 Krishna 的朋友。
So very few people are fortunate enough to know, to understand Krishna's identity.As the Supreme Lord.
只有很少的人，几乎没有人足够的幸运明白 Krishna 作为至尊主的地位和身份。
The impersonalists, they simply know him as the Brahman.
非人格主义者们只是认为 Krishna 就是梵。
So they can simply see Krishna as pure spirit. They see him as pure spirit, but they don't see him as the supreme Brahman.
他们只把 Krishna 当作纯粹的灵魂来看待，他们并没有认识到 Krishna 是至尊的梵。
And even Vaishnava devotees.They may only realize Krishna as having a body of eternal bliss and knowledge.
即便有的 Vaishnava 奉献者也只是认识到 Krishna 拥有永恒之时和极乐的身体。
So they worship Krishna and they experience some bliss, they get some pleasure from that.
所以他们就崇拜 Krishna, 并且从中得到一些快乐。
But the gopis in Vrindavan, they understand Krishna as the son of Nanda Maharaj, they're not worried about knowledge or reverence, giving great respect to anything.They simply know him as the son of Nanda Maharaj.
Vrindavan 的 gopi 牧牛姑娘们把 Krishna 当作 Nanda 大君的儿子，他们并没有那么多的知识，他们对 Krishna 也没有满怀敬畏之情和尊重之情。
So in this way, they can experience the greatest love for Krishna.
他们如此体验到对 Krishna 最了不起的爱。
This is the special nature of pure love for Krishna.
这是对 Krishna 满怀纯粹之爱的表现。
And this is described in many places here in the Brihad Bhagavatamrita.
这一点在这部大伯加瓦坦甘露。
So the gopis always feel so much love for Krishna. They cannot be with Krishna during the day. But (clears throat) When they meet him in the night, they do not feel so free to enjoy with him as they would like.
那些牧牛姑娘们对Krishna怀着如此的爱恋，她们白天不能跟Krishna在一起，到了晚间的时候，她们也不能自由自在地享受与对Krishna的爱。
The problem is because there's always a fear of opposition from their husbands and from their families.
问题就在于，他们总是担心他们的丈夫和家人的反对。
But the cowherd boys, they don't have this problem. They're always free to play with Krishna. Whether it's at home or in the forest, they can play with Krishna without any problem. They don't have to worry about their husbands or their wives or their families.
来自于丈夫，来自于自己的妻子和家人的反对，他们可以自由自在地就跟Krishna玩耍。
So you can see, in some ways, the cowherd boys are more fortunate than the gopis.
从这一点中可以看出，这些牧牛童们比牧牛姑娘更加幸运。
At the same time, we know from Srimad Bhagavatam that the greatest devotees and the most fortunate of all the devotees are the gopis.
与此同时，圣典菩萨瓦坛也声明，最伟大的以及最幸运的是那些牧牛姑娘。
And that tells us that Sukadeva Goswami, he's also a follower of the gopis' mode of devotion.
并且告诉人们，就是Sukadeva Goswami也是他们，就是他以这种心态的奉献者的追随者。So
while Sukadeva Goswami is describing about Krishna's pastimes and he's glorifying the cowherd boys for playing with Krishna, but he speaks like the gopis themselves. He speaks like a gopi. Although he's actually glorifying the cowherd boys, he's speaking in the mood of the gopis. Sukadeva Goswami praises the gopis that they are the most fortunate.
Sukadeva Goswami 赞扬那些牧牛姑娘们，称他们是最幸运的人。
In the same way, the gopis, they describe themselves. They describe the perfection of vision as the sight of Lord Krishna's face when he's going, when he's playing in the forest.
牛姑娘们自己描述说，描述Krishna说，世欲的完美就是去看Krishna的莲花脸，是当Krishna去森林玩耍的时候，能够得以见到Krishna的脸。
Yeah, the gopis say, oh, just see the eyes, just see the beautiful face of the son of Nanda Maharaj, the people who can see this face are certainly the most fortunate.
牧牛姑娘们说，看看Krishna的眼睛吧，看看Krishna美丽的脸庞吧，能够见到一些景象的眼睛，无疑是最幸运的。
Yeah, the gopis say, to be able to see Krishna and Balaram with their friends, entering into the forest, surrounded by cows, and playing their flutes, and they're glancing everywhere at the people of Vrindavan, Is it just to see that is the greatest, it's the most wonderful thing to see.
Krishna, Balarama, Krishna 吹奏着笛子，他的目光四下扫视，能见到这样的美景是最了不起的情况。
So in this way, the gopis are describing their good fortune.
母牛姑娘们就这样描述着他们的好运。
So yogis, they can do austerities and penances for many births.
瑜伽师们生生世世的进行严酷的苦行和忏悔。
So after a long time, they may be able to control their mind, but they'll not be able to. They still won't be able to taste even one bit of dust from the lotus feet of Krishna.
经过长时间的苦行忏悔。瑜伽师们也许能控制自己的心意，但是尽管如此，他们也不能品尝到来自 Krishna 莲花族的尘土的滋味。
So just imagine how fortunate the people of Vrindavan are, because they personally lived and saw Krishna face to face.
由此可以想象，文达姆并没有幸运了。他们得以亲自的和 Krishna 生活在一起，能够亲眼的面对面的见到 Krishna。
So these cowherd boys, they were able to see Krishna face to face, and they were even able to play with Krishna every day.
这些牧牛童朋友不仅能面对面的见到 Krishna， 还得以每天跟他一起玩耍。
So the cowherd boys and all the people of Vrindavan, they're the most fortunate people in the whole creation, because they can see, they can look on the beauty of Krishna.
So Vrindavan 的这些男孩子们以及那里的居民们都是整个创造当中最幸运的灵魂，因为他们可以
Some yogis, they may try to approach Krishna, but all they can hope to do, they try very hard, but they can never hope to become as fortunate as the people of Vrindavan.
但是他们永远不能指望能够得到像文达文居民那样的幸运。
Yeah, because they don't follow in the footsteps of the devotees of Vrindavan, so they cannot get even one bit of dust from Krishna's feet.
他们因为无法追随文达文奉献者的步伐，所以得不到 Krishna 莲花足下。
We should understand what it means when we talk about the dust from Krishna's feet. It can mean many different things.
When we talk about Krishna 莲花族的尘土的时候，我们当明白，这可能意味着有很多含义。
It could mean one atom of his feet.
其中一个含义也许是指他的莲花族的一粒原子。
Or it can mean the marks on his footprints in the dust of Vrindavan.
也可能意味着他莲花族上的那些印记，或者是他莲花族上的尘埃。
Or it might be dust that was in contact with his lotus feet and then it fell off.When Krishna was walking in the forests of Vrindavan.
这也可能是指当 Krishna 在 Vrindavan 的森林行走的时候，从他的莲花足掉下来的一粒尘土。
Or it could be anything which was even, it was not directly in contact with his feet. Doesn't matter how far away.
Sorry, didn't catch the meaning.
It can mean anything which is even not, it's not directly in touch with his feet, but it's,
oh, okay.
It's somewhere, you know, some distance away from Krishna.
也可能另外一个含义是指，并不是指任何跟 Krishna 莲花足直接有接触的事物，而是指跟离 Krishna 莲花足很远的事物。
It can even refer to the effulgence which comes from Krishna's favorite trees in Vrindavan, in the forests of Vrindavan.
也可能是指来自于 Krishna 最喜欢的 Vrindavan 的树木放出的光灿。
Krishna's favorite trees are trees like the Kadamba.
Krishna 最喜爱的树木也有 Kadamba 树。
So, even for some yogi to get that contact with something like that, like even something which is quite far away from Krishna, it's a great blessing for a mystic yogi.
而瑜伽师们能够接触到甚至离 Krishna 很遥远的事物，对于这个玄秘瑜伽师来说也是莫大的荣幸。
As some yogis, they will do a lot of austerity. They'll become brahmachari, practice celibacy for a long time, and they will struggle to control the mind and the senses, to take the mind and the senses away from material things.
瑜伽师们他们会长期做苦行坚守，他们挣扎着控制自己的心意与感官，把注意力从物质的事物上拿开移开。
But even if they reach to the samadhi, to the stage of samadhi, still they will not be able to approach Krishna. He's beyond their power of their senses.
但是即便他们已经深达了 samadhi 神定的层面，也无法接近 Krishna， 因为 Krishna 超越了他们的感官范畴。
Only the Brijbasis can see Krishna as he really is. So the form of Krishna is not just simply one of God's opulences. It's not just like a vibhuti, like in chapter 10 of the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna describes his vibhutis. The form of Krishna is not just like that.
Krishna 的形象并不像《薄伽梵歌》第十章所描述的神圣的赋予 vibhuti， 他的形象不仅局限于此。
So the form of Krishna is not just an incarnation, and he's not just even Lord Narayan, but he's the original source of all the forms of God. And this personality, this supreme personality, he is constantly fixed in the minds of these cowherd boys, and their eyes will never go away from him.
Those who 把自己的目光专注于像木
So very hard to describe how fortunate the people of Vrindavan are that they can see Krishna like this. So we may ask a question, we may ask it, maybe is the condition of the Brijbasi people, is this the result of their fate? Well, their situation, the Brijbasi people's situation is not karma. It's not the effect of just pious work in the previous life. It's the result of Krishna's mercy. So the condition of the Brijbasi people is it's like a constant festival, they're good, they're so fortunate that it's inconceivable. So, you know, Sukadeva Goswami was describing, he was going like from one level to another, higher and higher to greater devotees. So here, he's been telling about the good fortune of seeing Krishna. But before that, he told about the good fortune of the cowherd boys being able to play with Krishna. So we may wonder, is it more fortunate to see Krishna than to be able to play with Krishna? Of course, people who play with Krishna, like the cowherd boys playing with Krishna, that will also include seeing Krishna, because they're playing with him, so certainly they can see him. And we'll go beyond just simply seeing him. So we may think that playing with Krishna should come after seeing Krishna, and then playing with Krishna is on a higher level. But you have to understand it in another way. You have to understand what Sukadeva Goswami's meaning is. Certainly the boys who play with Krishna are very fortunate. And all the people in Vrindavan are very fortunate. And any resident in Vrindavan is greater than any yogi. So the boys who live with Krishna, who are very close with Krishna, who are living with him, they're so dear to Krishna that they're the best, they're the most fortunate of all the living beings. So we could see Sukadeva Goswami, he is glorifying the cowherd boys in particular. Of all the inhabitants of Vrindavan, the cowherd boys are very fortunate because Krishna is the object of their vision constantly.
Sukadeva Goswami, he is glorifying these young boys in particular.
So these cowherd boys, they're constantly seeing Krishna. And they don't see anything else. Now, our sense of sight, it can only see forms. It cannot smell anything. It cannot taste anything. There's no other sensation going to come. From the eyes, we're only going to see form. Eyes of other people, ordinary people, they will see things like cloth and pots, but the cowherd boys, their eyes only see Krishna. They see everything in relationship to Krishna.
他们的眼里一切都是跟Krishna有关联的。
Wherever they look, in every direction, in every corner, they see only Krishna.
无论他们的目光扫向哪里，无论他们的目光落到哪个角落，只有Krishna。
So this is why Sukadeva Goswami put this verse, seeing Krishna after playing with Krishna. It said seeing Krishna is even greater than playing with Krishna.
Okay. So, Sukadeva Goswami used this word to emphasize seeing Krishna is even greater than playing with Krishna.
Yeah, the cowherd boys are very fortunate to be able to play with him, but they're even more fortunate when they're able to see him everywhere.
毫无疑问，牧牛姑娘可以跟Krishna一起玩耍，是非常幸运的。然而，他们能够目光所到之处，只有Krishna，就地点，更加彰显了他们的幸运，他们的伟大。So
in this way, we can understand that the love of the cowherd boys for Krishna is almost like that, is almost as good as that of the gopis.
所以这样一来，我们就能够明白，牧牛童们对Krishna的爱，几乎可以跟牧牛姑娘跟Krishna的爱相媲美。
Now sometimes Krishna will get tired when they're fighting, and when he gets tired, he'll lay down on the bottom of the tree and he'll rest on a bed made of different soft twigs and buds. And he'll use the lap of the cowherd boy as his pillow. He'll lay down to rest.
有时候 Krishna 玩累的时候，跟牧牛童彼此之间，他们之间玩这个战斗的游戏累的时候，他会躺在树下，躺在一个用柔软的嫩枝和树叶铺成的软床上。他有时候会把牧牛童一位牧牛童的大腿当成枕头躺在上面。
So this way the cowherd boys, they're able to do service for Krishna. Right? This is actually taking place, this kind of leela will take place during Krishna's Poganda leela, means when he's between the age of 5 and 10. So Krishna was in the forest tending his cows with the cowherd boys, and they would enjoy, Krishna would enjoy laying down to take rest when he would get tired after fighting and wrestling, for example, he would get tired and then he would lay down, take a rest.
Krishna 很享受去森林和牧牛同放牧牛的消时光，他也享受跟牧牛童们玩摔跤游戏的消时光，他很喜欢就躺下来休息的消时光。
Or he'll lay sometimes on the banks of the Yamuna and enjoy the cool breeze coming off the Yamuna.
甚至有的时候他们就在雅穆的河岸边休息，享受着河水河面吹来的阵阵微风。
And he will lay under his favorite tree, like the Kadamba tree or the Tamala tree. And the goddess Vrinda, she's in charge of the Vrindavan forest. She will arrange for Krishna's pastime. She will arrange to have beds made of leaves and flowers and soft twigs just for Krishna to lay down on. Many devotees will be involved in making the beds, and they'll have, out of respect for Krishna's paraphernalia, they'll all compete to make different beds for Krishna to see which one he would like.
许多奉献者们都会参与制作 Krishna 休息用的这个床的消时光当中。出于对 Krishna 的随身用具的尊重，他们彼此之间在竞争，看谁能为 Krishna 做最让 Krishna 愉悦的软床。
And Krishna would expand himself, and he would be able to accept all the beds, because he'd made many beds, so Krishna would expand himself and he would be able to lay down on all the different beds just to satisfy and please all the boys.
Krishna, 为了满足这些朋友，他会把自己扩展，他接受他们制作的每一张床。
And he would accept for his pillow, he would have his very best friend, who is the brother of Srimati Radharani, Sridham. So some of the cowherd boys because they would massage his lotus feet, and others would fan him. Hare Krishna, Guru Mani. Sati.
Kumari?
Haribo, yeah, back now. Oh.
Hare Krishna.
I'm Hare Krishna.
Yeah, Hare Krishna, Ma. I'm here.
Okay.
Can you hear?
Yeah, yeah. I can hear you. Yeah. I got disconnected. Power's very unstable here. So,
okay.
So I was telling about some of the cowherd boys. They're all great souls, and they're able to massage Krishna's lotus feet, and some are fanning him.
刚才讲到了跟Krishna一起玩耍的那些男孩子们，全部都是伟大的灵魂。他们有的来为Krishna当Krishna休息的时候，有的前来为Krishna按摩，还有的上来给Krishna扇凉。Oh,
so when they could see Krishna was tired, then they would make arrangements to make him comfortable. And all the cowherd boys became very anxious about Krishna when they saw that he was tired, and they would all want to massage his legs.
看到Krishna疲累的时候，他们都很担心，所以他们纷纷过来被他按摩他的腿，双腿。
And to please his friends who all wanted to serve him, Krishna would manifest sometimes many different forms. He would expand himself so that they could all get an opportunity to serve him.
想要服务他的朋友，Krishna会把自己扩展出许多的形象，好让他们有机会来服务自己。But
they wouldn't know that Krishna was expanding. Each cowherd boy would think I'm massaging Krishna's feet.
但是那些男孩子们并不知道他们服务的是Krishna的扩展，他们认为他们每一个都在亲自。
So even in Krishna's childhood, he was displaying his power. Only the Supreme Lord can perform these kind of pastimes. So Krishna shows the greatness. He shows his greatness as the supreme.
He
shows it in these pastimes. It's even more convincing than when we see him doing the work of creation. And he attracts everyone by his sweetness. So Sukadeva Goswami describes that all these friends of Krishna, they had no sins. All of their sins, whatever sins they may have had, they were all destroyed. Now some ordinary people may be pious. But if they go against the principles of religion, that is sin.
有些普通人也许是虔诚人士，但是如果他们的行为违背了宗教原则的话，那么就会招致罪恶。
But for a devotee, sin is anything which is against pure devotional service.
对于奉献者而言，罪恶就是指的任何违背纯粹奉献服务的事物都被称之为罪恶。
So that is the meaning here, that the cowherd boys of Vrindavan, they didn't have any attachment, any interest at all to do anything that was not pleasing to Krishna.
所以这个对比的含义就是指当牧牛童们他们眼中的罪恶就是任何不取悦 Krishna 的任何事物，违背取悦 Krishna 的兴趣的任何事物，都被称之为罪恶。
And we should also understand that Krishna himself destroys the sins of the world.
应当明白 ，Krishna 本人。摧毁了世界的罪恶。
And he destroys the sins. The more he shows his glories, the more everyone gets to hear and chant about the pastimes and the glories of Krishna, then they can destroy all the sins of the world.
任何人倘若聆听和唱诵了 Krishna 的逍遥时光 ，Krishna 就会把他的罪恶摧毁。
Okay, so we will stop here today.
好，那我们讲课部分就停在这里。接下来我们看一下问题。第一个问题来自于真真，亲爱的 Hare Krishna， 亲爱的 Guru Maharaj， 请拜您甜美莲花族和所有奉献者，荣耀归于师的 Prabhupada。请问 Guru 下面的问题。如何用灵性的眼光看待人际关系和奉献者的关系和非奉献者的关系 ？So there are several questions from Zhen Zhen, Hare Krishna, dear Maharaj. Thank you, obeisance to your lotus feet, and all devotees. All glory to Shri Prabhupada. The first one is how to see relationship, our relationship, general relationship.And our relationship with devotees, and our relationship with non-devotees, from the point of a devotee.
Well, in relationship with devotees, there should be loving exchanges.
在奉献者之间的交往当中呢，应该有。满怀爱意的交流。
And these loving exchanges are described in the Nectar of Instruction by Rupa Goswami in the text number 1, 2, 3, 4. Text number 4.
圣入Rupa Goswami 不在教诲的甘露这部书当中的诗节四描述了与奉献者之间的爱心交流。
Yeah. With devotees, the loving exchange will be offering gifts and accepting gifts, offering prasadam, accepting prasadam, inquiring confidentially, and revealing your mind in confidence.
与奉献者之间的六项爱心交流是给予奉献者礼物，接受奉献者的礼物，给奉献者prasadam，还有接受奉献者的prasadam。向奉献者询问机密的话题，以及揭示向奉献者揭示自己的心声，吐露心声。
And but non-devotees, with non-devotees, people who are not devotees, how will we relate to them? Well.Respectfully, we'll deal with them, but we won't have the same intimate affection for them.
至于跟 见者的交流呢，我们是尊重他们的，但是我们不会跟他们有这种亲密的爱意的交流。
We will see them. There are some people there, innocent. So we can be affectionate to them, be compassionate to them.
对于那些无知之人呢，我们是对他们怀着怜悯之情，我们也怀有爱之情。
But some people who are openly antagonistic and very aggressive and very offensive, then we will avoid them.
而对那些心怀就是有侵犯性的，还有那些强烈反对的人，还有那些怀着冒犯的人，我们会避而远之。
Yes.
Okay. The next one, 灵魂的具体职责是什么呢？What indeed is the duty of the soul? What's the specific duty of the soul?
The duty of the soul is to engage in the service of Lord Krishna.
灵魂的职责就是从事于服务 Krishna.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Jivesvarupahaya Nitya Krishna Das.The soul is eternally the servant of Krishna. It's his constitutional position. Constitution means doesn't change. It's always servant of Krishna.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说 Jivesvarupa. 这句诗文的意思就是说灵魂是 Krishna 的永恒仆人，而且灵魂的不成性地位就是服务。不成性地位的意思就是说它是永恒不变的，是永恒的。
Yes.
The next one, 我获得的工资里面是不是也有业报？我买回来的家用物品也可以供奉吗？ As far as the salary, is concerned, are there any karma?Related to my salary?
Yes, everybody gets karma. You're working for people, you'll get some karma, yeah?
是的，任何事物都是有业报的，因为你在为别人工作，所以有业报。Shall I offer the items I bought?
Yes, you should, whatever.
可以。
Should offer to Krishna.
是的，买回来的那些家用品应该供奉 Krishna. If I borrow money from others, if I lend my money to others, so what specific karma does this karma belong to?
Yeah, well, you borrow money or you lend money to others. Yeah, there's karma involved in that. Yeah.
She asked,
You're taking money from someone, so you're taking their money, you're taking some of their karma.
如果你接受了别人的金钱，你同时也接受了别人的业报。
And if you give money to somebody else, and they use your money,And now if they're doing something sinful with the money you gave them, then you'll also get karma.
你把钱借给别人，用来做罪恶的活动的话，那么你也要分享他们做的罪恶的结果。
嗯哼。
怎么样过没有业报的生活呢？ How can I live a life that is...without karma.
You have to dedicate everything in the service of Krishna.
你必须把一切都供奉给对 Krishna 的服务。
Yes. All your money. All your money, all your time, everything in the service of Krishna.
你的所有金钱都 钱、您的时间、您的一切都用来服务 Krishna。
Of course, karma can be good. There can be good karma, there can be bad karma. Some karma will bring happiness, some karma will bring suffering.
业报它分为善业、恶业。善业它会给人以快乐，恶业会给人以痛苦。
So some people, they want to enjoy the good karma, but when you enjoy the good karma, there will always be some bad karma with it as well.
有些人他们乐于享受自己的善业，但是在享受善业的同时又会不可避免的也会有一些恶业。
Yeah, you can't have all good karma. There's going to be always something bad.
你不可能一切都是好的善业，总会有一些恶业。Next one. 下一个是来自 Shruti Rupa Devadasi， 顶拜 Guru 和老师们。这段时间我在生活中观察到，自己只要进入功利性活动，内心就会马上紧张、焦虑、沮丧。但是，只要与学习、分享经典和奉爱方面的事情，哪怕再忙，我的内心也非常喜悦、心甘情愿。现在祈求孤乐仁慈，请您祝福我，把心理咨询作为工具和工作，更好的学习、实践传播 Krishna 之觉。Awaits the Guru and teachers. During this period.I observed in my daily life that as soon as my activity is that of karma activity, I will feel intense anxiety and depressed. But if I share the scripture and devotional life, then even if I'm so busy, I feel very peaceful and I'm very happy to do these things.Now I have two blessings from Guru. The first blessing is that please bless me that I can use the psychological advisory as a tool to better spread Krishna consciousness and better use it in my service, in my study.In my practice of Krishna consciousness. So this is the first blessing from Guru. The next one is Guru 祝福我能够控制嘴巴，少吃点 prasadam。我现在碰到没人相信我吃素的了。The next one is Guru please bless me that I can control my tongue to less prasadam because now I'm so fat that nobody believe that I'm a vegetarian.
Yeah.
另外报告公布好消息，我母亲现在已经主动烹饪、住持、念诵圣名、供奉了，很感恩咕噜。Next, I will report the guru a good news that my mother has now volunteered.Cook vegetarian and chant the holy name and make offerings. Thank you, Guru.
Okay, we bless your mother that she'll chant the holy name and make offering. Yeah.
She said her mother has already done that.
Her mother has already done that. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. 好的，那 Guru 就刚才已经祝福您了，出题出分，妈的姐。
Radhastami.
You and Jabhavaraj. You and Jabhavaraj.
Me and who?
Jabhavaraj.
Jabhavaraj.
Your class 6 to 7:30.
6 to 7.
6:30 to 7:30.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you, Maharaj.
Okay, Jishu.
Okay.下一个是来自于这个华为 Honor， 顶拜 Mara 做奉献者。印度现在的温达文属于印度管辖吗？是不是温达文居民都是 Krishna 的奉献者呢？ This devotee is asking that is Vrindavan, nowadays Vrindavan in India, does it belong to the control of India? And does the Rajabasi here in on the earth, India, do they belong to the control of the Indian government? Does all the Rajabasi, are they all devotees of Krishna?
Yes, all the Brijbasi people are devotees of Krishna. And yes, Vrindavan on the map is a part of India, and the people in Vrindavan are Indian. But that is just in the material sense. But you have to understand, you don't go to Vrindavan just by buying a ticket. Vrindavan is not just some place on the map. You have to understand, to go to Vrindavan, to really enter Vrindavan, you have to change your consciousness.
是的，文达文的居民都是Krishna的奉献者，而且现在的文达文居民也是属于印度管辖。但是，就是文达文，它不是一个地图上的概念。所以，你不是买一张机票就能去文达文的，你必须得改变知觉才能去。See,
there's many people in Vrindavan. They're not really Brijbasi people. They come from other places, but the people who are really the Brijbasi people, they're very, very great devotees, and in their heart they have so much love for Krishna.
现在的Vrindavan很多人是来自外地的，所以他们不是真正意义上的 Rajabasi, Vrindavan居民, 也有一些当地的
Yeah. When in the month of Kartik, then they have the parikrama. And so at that time, you can walk through the 12 forests of Vrindavan. And you can meet, you can go to the Vrijbasi people, you can meet them, you can go to their home. And sometimes you also have kirtan with them. They're very great devotees.
在Kartika月当中，有一个月的Kartika月，奉献者们会绕拜文达文的十二座森林。在这绕拜期间呢，你就可以去一些当地的文达文的居民的家中，可以去见到他们，和他们一起贴他，他们是伟大的奉献者。
Okay.
Next one from Yuna. Yuna. Hare Krishna. Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. If we do not ask Krishna for protection in a difficult situation, can we hope that he already knows about our problems and will come to protect us? Or is it better to ask him all the same? 这个问题来自 Yuna. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj. 你接受我辈的顶拜。 如果我们在困境当中不要求 Krishna 保护我们，我们能不能指望 Krishna 就已经知道我们的问题，来自动的过来保护我们呢？或者是我们最好还是主动的要求 Krishna 保护呢？也一样呢
？Yes, it's a question of the individual. What is your, you know, situation? Is it a very desperate situation? You're very desperate, you may want to pray to Krishna for protection. We cannot imitate Prahlad Maharaj. Prahlad Maharaj, he doesn't have to pray to Krishna for protection because he's always remembering Krishna. So if you're always remembering Krishna, you don't need to pray to Krishna for protection. But we're not on that level. So then you have to pray to Krishna.
是一个因人而异的问题，你得看您个人的处，您的处境是不是一种很绝望的处境，必须得向 Krishna 祈求保护。我们也不能模仿 Prahlad 大军，因为他时刻的是记住 Krishna 的，永远不会忘记 Krishna， 所以他不用祈求 Krishna 保护。 但是我们如果处在这种绝望的处境，我们必须得向 Krishna 祈求保护。
Even Lord Chaitanya was going through the forest of Vrindavan. I was going through the forest Jarakanda. And so he was chanting Krishna Krishna Pahimam, Krishna Krishna Rakshamam. He was chanting to Krishna, protect me, save me. Of course, we could say, well, he was just singing like that, but maybe he also is praying to Krishna. He's showing us the example.
但是主柴丹加玛巴布穿越加日康的森林的时候，他也唱这个一首歌，Krishna，Pahimam，Rakshamam。你可能会说，他只不过是嘴上唱着而已，但是他也是在这样的祈祷着，所以他给我们树立了一个榜样。
Okay.
下一个问题，Vedavati， 明白Guru，怎样正确对待灵性竞争？发现自己哪里都有竞争，就不自觉的远离，这也是感恩享乐吗？怎么改变 ？Obvious Guru， how can we face the situation of competition correctly? Because wherever I go, I found there will be competition.Even in the spiritual sense, so that I will keep it very far away from it. Is it a kind of sense gratification? How can I change myself? How can I see correctly face the problem of spiritual competition?
Yes, well, we have to understand it's service to Krishna. It's not.You have to understand competition is not just simply the results, you know, but it's how much we're able to be Krishna conscious, how much we've remembered Krishna. That's the important thing. Generally, when we talk of competition, it's all based on results. You know, how many books did you distribute? How much money did you collect? How many, you know, we look at numbers.But actually, the real competition is how much we remember Krishna.
通常的时候，就是人们竞争，创建者竞争的时候，他们都在竞争的是结果，看谁派出量多，看谁那个就是收集的钱，捐款多。但是真正的竞争，实际上应该竞争的是，到底有是到底。
So we can pray to other devotees, we can ask other devotees, you can appreciate their service and tell them, oh, you serve Krishna so nicely, please bless me that I can also serve Krishna.
我们可以向另外一位就是奉献者祈祷，欣赏他，首先是欣赏他，他的服务，对他说，你的服务那么好，你祝福我，也能做好我的服务。
So, competition, Prabhupada encouraged devotees in the West and in the beginning of our movement, Prabhupada encouraged devotees that this competition was not material, it is for the service of Krishna, distributing books.
在我运动的一开始呢，帕布帕德是鼓励竞争的，就这种竞争呢，它不是一种物质的竞争，而是为了服务 Krishna。帕布帕德就鼓励奉献者的派书。
But we should understand that even somebody may win the competition, it doesn't mean that he was the best devotee.
但是我们要明确一点，就是那些在这个竞争当中取胜的奉献者，并不意味着他们就是最好的、最优秀的奉献者。
Very nice. Yeah. Okay.
Lassie, 自己工作挣到的钱也是得到别人的业报吗？ Lassie, Mataji asked that if we earn our salary, is it also that we have to accept karma from others?
Well, yes. In everything we do, there's going to be some kind of karma.So you're working for people, you're working people, they're not ordinary people, not devotees, and they pay you some money. So there's some karma involved, you know, with that money. And it's up to you how you use that money, you know, but it depends also on your consciousness, you know. If you're working in the sense that you're working for Krishna, then you're actually really conscious of Krishna in the course of your work, then there'll be less karma involved.
是的，就是一切都有 karma。如果我们为非奉献者工作的话，他们给我们钱，那我们就接受了他们 karma。但是这也得取决于您自己怎么用这个钱，您的知觉是什么。而且呢，就是如果我们是为 Krishna 工作，我们在整个工作的过程当中呢，我们始终都是知觉着 Krishna 的话，那么这样的意义上，那么就没有那么多的业报了。
The next one?
Yeah.
下一个仆人，明白Guru有俩问题，我无法做到早起，一边不吃晚餐，睡得很早，仍然起得晚，睡眠时间长，这是不是愚昧形态？我很沮丧，如何调整？ Two questions from a servant, a business guru, the two questions. I cannot get up early, even if I do not eat dinner in the night, and even if I go to sleep early, and still I cannot get up early. My sleeping time is very long. Is it that I'm situated in the mode of ignorance? I'm very depressed. How can I adjust myself?
Well.We usually, Prabhupada said, we don't want to sleep more than 8 hours.
Prabhupada 说过，通常呢，我们的睡眠应该不超过8小时。
And he said, actually, 6 hours should be enough. But you need more, okay. Maybe you're more physical, more emotional, you use up a lot of energy.So you can sleep a bit more, 7 hours, but shouldn't be more than 8 hours.
而且就是说，帕帕也说过，6个小时就足够了。但是呢，如果您的身体、您的体力消耗的能量多，而且您的情感活动消耗的能量多，那么也就是就您的睡眠要超过6个小时，这也是可以。理解的，但是呢，不应该超过8小时睡眠。
You definitely want to be conscious about sleeping. It is. Prabhupada says sleeping is like death. So we should be regulated. You have to try to regulate your sleeping. Sleep at the same time and get up at the same time.
我们应该知觉到我们的睡眠。帕帕说，睡眠就好像死亡一样。那您应该规范自己的睡眠，就是按时睡觉，按时起床。
And it's better if you can sleep earlier in the night. Don't sleep too late.
最好您头天晚上要早睡，不要睡得晚。
The sleep you get before midnight, 1 hour before midnight is like 2 hours in sleep after midnight.
就是在午夜十二点之前的睡眠的一个小时时间的质量，就相当于子夜就十二点钟之后睡觉的质量，就是十二点之前的睡眠的一个小时，相当于十二点之后睡觉的两个睡了俩小时。
And you should be careful about eating at night. Don't eat heavy food at night.
您也要小心您头天晚上的晚餐，就不要吃那个很难消化的食物，要吃一些清淡好消化的食物。
Right. If you eat after it, Prabhupada told us he didn't want us to eat grains after 4 in the evening. After 4 in the afternoon, we shouldn't take grains.
有关于就是晚餐地点呢，帕帕德的教导是，就是下午4点之后呢，就不要再进食谷类了，五谷。
So you can take some boiled vegetables, you can take some fruit, you could take some hot milk, like that.
您的晚餐就是下午四点以后呢，可以吃一些水煮蔬菜，还有水果，或者是热牛奶。
But don't eat heavy.
但是不要吃那些难消化的，厚重的食物。
That would make it easier for you to wake up in the morning.
这样一来，您早上呢就能很容易的醒来。
Good association is also very helpful.
好的联谊也是至关重要的，也是很有帮助的。
If you're staying with somebody who also sleeps late, then it will be hard for you to wake up.
如果您和那些有晚睡习惯的人联谊的话，那您自己早起也不太容易。
You can give your phone number to your friend and have them call you early in the morning.
您可以把您的电话号码告诉朋友，让他们第二天清晨呢早上叫您起床。
Yeah. They can call you in the morning and say, "Are you up yet? Did you start chanting yet?"
他们会就是这些奉献者会给您打电话，你起来了没有？你念诵开始念诵了吗？
So you have to have a strong desire. You have a bad habit to sleep a lot. You have to conquer over it. You have to change. You can do it. Krishna will help you.
现在你已经有了这个愿望，但是之前呢，你已经养成了一些坏习惯，但是您必须得改变这些习惯。您一定能做到的。Krishna 一定会帮助您的。下一个，第二，家里长辈向我要钱，用于布施给佛教庙，我该不该给 ？My senior in the family asked money from me to donate the money to the Buddhist temple. Shall I give the money?
Well, if you have an obligation to them, you can give some small donation.
如果呢，您亏欠他们，您对他们有这种职责和义务的话，您可以给他们少量的钱。
But usually the Buddhist temples have a lot of money. They don't need much money.
佛教的庙很有钱，他们缺钱。
So you give donate, you can give something, you put some small amount in the hongbao.
您就可以，给一点，给少的钱，给点红包，意思。
And you have to say, you know, I don't have a lot of money, I'll give something, but can't give much.
您可以告诉他们，哎呦，我的钱不多，我不能给您很多钱。
Okay.
好，下一个来自于这个 Novel 五，顶拜咕噜。他对所有人说，顶拜咕噜工作的职责在烟草上班，这有业报吗？ Obvious guru, I work in the family that produce cigarette. Are there any karma?
Yes. Yes, there's karma.
有业报。
When devotees were working, before also, devotees were working in cigarette factory. Prabhupada said, no, you cannot work there. You have to change that job.
在帕帕德的那个时代也有奉献者就在烟草公司工作。后来帕帕德就对这个奉献者说，你不能在这个行业工作，你不应该为此而工作。
Because, yes, that's cigarettes, you know, it's not something we want to promote. We don't smoke cigarettes, and we don't want to encourage other people to smoke cigarettes.
我们不想推广烟草行业，我们自己从来不抽烟，我们也不会鼓励别人去抽烟。
So try to find another job.
所以，请您换一份工作。
Yes.
Brajarani Devadasi, 对所有人说，顶拜 Guru Day, 顶拜所有的奉献者。最近有俩新人都是念佛的，一个是痛苦，遇到很多痛苦事儿，快到崩溃了，就想找一个另外一个修行方法。有一天他遇到我，他以为我在修佛，就咨询。我跟他说我念 Krishna 的名字，他听了以后开始念，挺真诚。他身体也有问题，但是念诵以后心情和身体都改变了。他就跟他念佛的朋友说，就带朋友来吃本沙的。那朋友听了 Krishna 之后也开始念了，但是不是很认真。念了没一天，他说他现在身体特别不舒服，浑身疼，颈椎也疼。他问是不是念诵圣名的原因。说 Brother Rani said that there are two devotees, they are all Buddhist before.One friend is very painful before, even to the point of devastation. Therefore, she wanted to change to another practice. And one day she met me and asked me, and I shared Krishna's holy name with her. And after that, she began to chant and very sincerely. And her health problem changed and her feeling also changed. Therefore, she shared this method to another Buddhist friend and took that friend to my home to honor Prasad. And after that, her friend also began to chant holy name, but not so serious. After 3 days, her friend said that she felt very uncomfortable in the body and she felt very painful all over the body andThere's neck problem also. She felt very painful in the neck. She asked, is this because of She's chanting the holy name.
No, shouldn't. I don't think her health problems are because she's chanting the holy name. Must be some other reason.
不是，就是她的健康问题肯定不是因为唱诵圣名，是别的问题。
She doesn't have faith in the holy name. That's a problem.
问题是出在她对圣名没有信心。
If she had faith in the holy name, she'd feel the effect of the holy name, and she'd feel happy, and she'd feel free, like the other lady, like the first lady.
如果她对圣名有信心，她就会感到念诵的效果，她就会内心快乐，她就会感到自由自在，像她的那个把她带进来的那个朋友。
Yeah, the first lady who came, she chanted and she got better. It cured her health problem. So how could the other lady, she chants and she gets a health problem?
那么把她带到您家中的那个一位，她念诵了圣名之后，她的健康问题就得到了改善，她的问题就解决了。那怎么可能她带进来的这个朋友，她的健康都会出问题呢？
Okay.
Chaitanya Charan, Hare Krishna, Dimbai Gurudeva. Sakam Karma Yoga 有业报吗？跟 Karma Panda 是一样的吗？有何区别？ Hare Krishna versus Gurudeva. Are there any karmic reaction in Sakam Karma Yoga?
Well, in Sakam Karma Yoga, one is attached to, there's still some attachment to the results of the work. So yes, there will be still some karma there.
Sakam Karma Yoga, 它是仍然依附工作结果，因此有业报的。
You haven't surrendered the results, so you're going to get some karma.
他没有把工作结果臣服工作结果，所以有业报。Sakam Karma Yoga 就是怀着欲望的业余家。What's the difference between他跟 Karma Panda 是一样的吗？ Is it the same as Karma Panda? What's the difference?
Is what the same as Karma Panda?
Sakam Karma Yoga, is it the same as Karma Kanda?
No, not the same. Karma Kanda are activities which are done simply for the pleasure of our material body, but they're done according to the Vedas. You're performing Vedic rituals, usually like worshipping demigods, and we want to get some material result for ourselves.
Karmakanda 是只为了取悦物质身体而履行的活动，是按照韦达经所说的履行了仪式，也涉及到办事人，他的物质结果就是为了自己。
But karma yoga, sakama karma yoga, at least we recognize the supreme is there. There's some connection to the supreme.So the work is done in connection with the Supreme Lord.
但是在 Karma Yoga 业余活动瑜伽当中，他是承认有一个尊者存在着的，他的工作也是和至尊主联系在一起的。
But we're still attached. We're attached to the work and we're attached to the results.
但是我们仍然依附工作，我们仍然依附工作结果。
But we recognize there is the Supreme.
但是我们意识到了，我们承认有一位至尊者。
But Karma Kanda, we haven't recognized the Supreme.
但是在 Karma Kanda 之部，我们并没有承认有一位至尊者。
Yeah.
下一位喜浪对所有人说，顶拜 Guru Maharaj， 顶拜所有的奉献者，昨天儿子婚礼，亲朋好友前来随喜，因为说服不了家人，所以喜宴有肉食，但同时我派发了1000多份不扎的，想让来宾得到灵性净化，这样是否能抵消业报呢？ Vincent Guru Maharaj and all devotees, yesterday my son held the ceremony, marriage ceremony, and a lot of friends and relatives come and give money, 红包. And because my family member, due to my family members, there are veg meat in the meal.But at the same time, I distributed 1,000 prasad, so that the guests can get spiritual purification. So my question is that, can that counteract the karma?
What did she do to counteract the karma?
She distributed 1,000 copy of prasad. She didn't say what kind of prasad, but she distributed the prasad for one. The number is 1,000.
Yeah. Well. No, there's still going to be karma there.
还是会有业报。
You can't. Of course, it was good you distributed prasadam. That's nice, but still, there will be some good karma, some bad karma.
还是会有业报的。当然，您派发prasadam 非常好，但是就是。你在这个活动过程当中，既会有好的业报，也会有坏的业报。
Yes, you distribute the prasadam. That's good karma. You get, of course, you can say, is it devotional service? I don't know. You were distributing the prasadam to destroy the sinful effects of your bad karma. You were not doing it just simply for Krishna.
那您那个派了1000多份普沙的，至于这是不是奉献服务，这也难说，因为您是为了摧毁恶业才做的，并不是为了取悦 Krishna 做的。
Yeah, when we distribute prasadam, we want to distribute simply for the pleasure of Krishna.
我们派普沙的时候，我们的动机。
Not just simply to destroy our sinful reactions. So, anyway, now your son is married, so now that's over with, so now you're free, you can go on.With devotional service.
现在您的孩子也儿子结婚了，您也自由了，那么您可以继续做您的奉献服务了。
Yeah, don't have anything to do with meat or fish or egg.
那么就不应该沾鱼肉蛋。She distributed cookie sweets, prasad and.Western style.
Yeah, very nice. So continue to do that.
很好，您继续这么做。The next one.
Yeah.
Yogita Sharma. Gurudev Panho, O Lord Shri Prabhupada. Gurudev There are also people who are born in Vrindavan who are very greedy and do not speak in a nice way. How should we look at such people? Why would such people be born in Vrindavan? Gurudev, 在 Vrindavan 也有一些人生下来就很贪婪，而且他们言语也不很优雅。他们，我们怎么能看待这些人？他们怎么会诞生在 Vrindavan 呢？
Well, they're not really the Brijbashi people. They're other people. Maybe they come from outside.
他们不是 Brijbashi 居民，他们是别的人，他们是来自，他们是外来的。Another question, Gurudev. People who go to Golok never return to the material world. What about people who are born in Goloka and not in this material world? Are they going to go straight to Goloka, or is purification is also required by them? 另一个问题，去了 Goloka 的人永远不用返回物质世界。那么诞生在物质世界 Goloka 和 Vrindavan 的人又他们是怎么回事呢？他们会不会直接回 Goloka， 或者是还需要他们还需要进化呢？
Yes, well, it depends on their consciousness. You know, they're born in Goloka, they're born in Vrindavan, but we have to see how they, what they do with their life, how they use their life. They have to be, you know, it's a good birth to be born in Vrindavan, it's very good, but you have to see how people take advantage of that birth, what they do with their life.
他们出生在本大门，这是一个很好的出生，但是这也取决于他们该如何过他们这一生，他们的知觉如何。
Some people are born in Vrindavan and they just think, I want to go to the big city, I don't want to live here in this village, I want to go to the big city, I want to enjoy material life.
其中有一些人，他们的志向是去大城市过上享受的生活。
And some people, they're living in Vrindavan, but they're just doing business. They just want to make money. They're just there to do business and make money.
还有些在Vrindavan的人，他们就是想在Vrindavan赚钱。
So consciousness is very important.
知觉非常重要。
But it's certainly it's a good birth to take birth in Vrindavan. It's very fortunate, very rare birth.
能投生在Vrindavan 是特别的罕见和幸运的。
And it can be the last birth. They can go back to Godhead.
也可能是他们最后一世了，他们就完了，就回归神手了。
Prabhupada was very happy to go back to Vrindavan to leave the body. He thought it was important to him. He wanted to leave the body in Vrindavan.
帕帕德在最后的日子，他就回到 Vrindavan， 离开了躯体。对他来说，这个很重要。
So a good place, the best place to leave the body is in the holy dham.
所以最好的离开躯体的地方就是在圣地离开躯体。
But we can't all come to the holy place to leave the body. So wherever we are, want to somehow leave with the association of devotees.
但是不可能所有人都在圣地离开躯体。但是无论在哪里，最好是在奉献者的涟漪当中离开躯体。
Yeah, okay.
下一个Bhakti. A lot of questions there. Bhakti, 请问 Guru, 博家梵歌 1.42 提到的社会计划、家庭福利指哪些？ In Bhagavad Gita, chapter 1, verse 42, they mention about the social plan and family benefit. What does they mean? In which aspect that does this refer to?
Yeah, it's talking about different communities. They will have programs to help each other, to help the community, to help all the members in the community materially, to arrange their education or their hospital or like that. They will do this kind of work. They will have like a begin a school, or they will begin a hospital, or maybe a library or something like that. It will be sponsored by the community.
这指的就是由社团所发起的，就是在物质上的一些活动，比如说，电学校啊，电医院呐，电图书馆呐。Yeah,
I mean, we often see Chinese people do that. They go somewhere and they will all club together and they will make their own school.
那我们看到就是中...
That means outside of China. I'm talking about when they go out of China. You know, they get together and they arrange things like that for themselves.
就是这些中国人他们出了国之后呢，他们就是上学，就是自己安排他们的教育。
Yeah, they do different welfare programs, welfare projects.
他们就会这样举办各种就是福利计划。So
Arjuna is concerned. He said, if we kill all the elders, if we kill all the elder people, then he's worried that all these projects may stop because the young people become materialistic. They're not interested to do these kind of programs.
阿中呢就很关心这种问题，他说一旦长辈被杀的话，那么这些计划都会停止，因为年轻人他们就会有物质倾向，他们对这些没兴趣。Okay. There are still like maybe 7 or 8.
Okay, we'll keep going.
Okay, 那我们接着回答问题。下一个是来自于 Goloka Yoga 杨秀辉，顶拜 Guru Maharaj 问：念诵 Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya 和念诵 Mahamantra 有什么区别？我试着念诵 Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya， 觉得很有力量。What's the difference between chanting Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya and Mahamantra？And I felt it's very powerful to chant Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Yes, it's very powerful. It's the name of God.
是的，那这个曼陀罗很有力量，因为它是神的名字。
But we're following Lord Chaitanya.
但是我们在追随主切丹尼亚。
Lord Chaitanya chanting Hare Krishna.
Lord Chaitanya, he chants Hare Krishna.
So we have to chant Hare Krishna.
So we have to chant Hare Krishna.
But you can also chant Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Yeah. This one from Vivo 93, 顶拜古鲁奉献者，现在孩子大四毕业，一日主的仁慈，在哈市国企干了份没压力的工作，他 孩子不愿上班，还没什么想干的事儿，请您训示我，我该怎么办？让他每天说不上班的话，打扰的心都乱。My son, my child, he or she has graduated by the mercy of the Lord. He or she find a job in the government, in the government company. With this job, there is no any pressure for my child, but she is not willing to go there. Yet on another hand, there's not a better job for her to do. So please give me instruction, because what should I do? Because my son, he's always saying that he will not go to that job. I feel very disturbed in my mind.
Well, this is not something I can involve in. This is not a spiritual matter. I'm a spiritual teacher. I cannot help you in your family problems like this.
我是不能卷入这种事情的，因为这并不是灵性的事情。我是一个灵性老师，我不能帮助您来解决您个人的家庭问题。David. Next, David Darcy 请拜 Mara 像 John Master Me 这样的大节日供奉几十道大餐，摆满桌子，原来 挡在桌子上的屏风都挡不住了。念完供奉祷文，是不是不能在神像房间里等，应该到外面等待20分钟再进去？ David Darcy is asking that during the John Master Me festival we offer the 30 dishes on the offering desk. So the small shelf cannot prevent us from seeing all these dishes. So in that case, shall we go to outside the tea room and wait outside for 20 minutes to go in the place where the
Yes, that's a good thing.
是的，是。
Yes.
是的，应该在外面等。
Or else you can have people hold a cloth, get people to hold a cloth and go around and cover them.
或者您可以请两个人，就是每个人手里拿着一块布，扯着那个布啊，挡住这供的食物。巴拉特主题是宗教原则、经济发展、感官享乐、解脱吗？战争是哪一部分呢？感恩 ask Dima Gurde. Bharati is asking. The theme of Bharata is a religious principle, karma, artha, dharma, moksha. So what?Battlefield, which part does Mahabharata relate about a fight, war, the battle war?
I'm sorry, I'm not understanding.
She's confirming whether the theme of the Mahabharata.The theme of Mahabharata is religious principle, economic development, sense gratification, and liberation.
The theme of the Mahabharata? Well, yes, there's a lot of karmakandi activity like dharma, artha, kama, moksha, material religion. Yeah, there's a lot of these things in it. Mahabharata, you have to understand We don't have the whole Mahabharata. We only have part of it, because a lot of the Mahabharata is Grandfather Bhishma instructing Maharaj Yudhisthira. And usually people won't translate that part. They only translate the battle, because they think that the part where Bhishma is giving instruction to Maharaj Yudhisthira is too long, and there's so many things about how to rule and how to govern and how to guide the people and what you have to do to maintain the country, and there's all of these things. So people don't like to translate that, they just translate the battlefield. So you don't really know what's the whole Mahabharata.
就是整部《Mahabharata》并没有全部的翻译出来，因为有很大一部分内容讲的是，嗯，毕什么老祖父对优迪斯蒂尔大军的教导，嗯，其中的内容就包括怎样去统治国家、领导臣民治理国家，就这一部分呢，因为特别内容就特别长，所以没有被翻译出来。
But the Mahabharata definitely is not about love of God. Jiva Goswami said nobody got love of God by reading Mahabharata.
Jiva Goswami said Mahabharata
It's a lot of material religion, a lot of family problems, a lot of politics. That's what Mahabharata is all about. Okay.
下一个, Radhananda. Hare Krishna. 以前都是听说修习瑜伽不能睡太多，不能睡太少，睡眠时间在六小时。今天听马儿说是八小时，如果理解就多俩小时呢。
Well, it's not that some people. Prabhupada said generally 6 hours is enough. Yeah, generally 6 hours is enough, but some people need more. So okay, you need to sleep a little more. You can sleep a bit more, maybe you sleep 7 hours, but it shouldn't get to more than 8 hours. I mean, that is, if you're sleeping more than 8 hours, then you're sick. You have to find out what's wrong with you.
一般帕帕德说，一般而言，六小时的睡眠就足够了，但是有的人就需要多一点睡眠，就7个小时，但是不会多，但是呢，不能超过8小时。 如果是已经超过八小时的话，那说明这个人的身体有病，也就他应该去看看病，就看他身体哪里出了问题了。Okay，下一个问题。The next one，final one，工作只做服务，完全依靠Krishna，是不是就没有吧？因为don't go to work and earn money，因为don't only do bhakti devotional service and depend solely on Krishna to maintain us, and that there will be no karma.
Well, I don't know about that. I don't know. Can you just depend on Krishna to maintain you? That's not very good. We shouldn't just depend on Krishna to maintain us. We're supposed to work for Krishna. We like to give to Krishna, we don't like to take from Krishna. So if we don't work, then how do you maintain yourself? You cannot just ask Krishna to give you everything. Can it just expect Krishna to give you everything?
如果我们不工作，然后就指望着 Krishna 来维系我们，就期望着 Krishna 给我们一切。
So you have to be careful how you apply this philosophy. This is not very good. We're thinking that, oh, if I work, I get karma. If you don't work, you get karma also.
所以我们要小心我们的哲学了。就是如果，就是我们不要想着，如果工作的话会有业报，如果工作也有业报的。
Yeah, because we cannot be idle. We cannot do nothing.Right? We cannot stop. Bhagavad Gita, Krishna said, no one can be idle, not even for a moment. All men are forced to act helplessly due to the impulses of the modes of nature. So you're going to do something. You're going to eat, you're going to walk around, you're going to talk, you're going to do things, you're going to get karma.
就人不能就是闲待着，无所事事。就国家放歌说，人就是灵魂，它是无助的，都是在物质单形态的驱使下，在活动着。那你得吃饭吧，你得走路吧，你还得活动吧，那这些都会招致业报啊。
But if we work.And you sacrifice your hard-earned money for the service of Krishna, then you don't get karma.
但是如果我们工作，然后把我们赚的血汗钱来献给 Krishna， 这样就没有业报了。
All right, no more questions.
Yeah, yes.
Okay, very good. So, Vaman Ganshiya Guru Mani, Ki Vaman Jantai De Fan E, Vaman Ganshiya Saudi Fung Shien Sa Ling Ting, T1, Vaman Jufu Niman, Chuan Chao Shun Li, Chang Song Bing Kwai La, Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki.